Well, good morning and welcome to the Circle of Worship of St. Stephen's United Methodist Church in Norman, Oklahoma. Whether you're part of us here in the sanctuary or joining us virtually, we're glad that you are a part of this community's worship on this day. And we're also so glad that we have to hear from one of our bell choirs this morning. There are two bell choirs back in full force after being much reduced for a year and a half, so we're really happy to be able to share that. Today is All Saints Sunday, and here in a few minutes we will be bringing in the tintinnabulum, which has the ribbons, it has the names of those that we have loved and are gone, and we will be reading the names of our congregation who have passed on during the past year. Also, it's Communion Sunday, and so if you are worshiping in person, when you take communion, you will come up, you will get your small piece of bread and your communion cup, and take them back to your seats. And then when we've all been served, we will take communion together. So for those of you who are present, that's how we will do that. There are some white buckets around for you to put the little recyclable communion cups in once they're empty. Also, this week on Thursday, the Lunch Bunch will be gathering. So if you have been a part of that or you're interested in being a part of that, bring your lunch, and on Thursday at noon, they'll either be outside on the Rainbow Crosswalk, or if it's too cold, inside in the loggia. So they've been having a great time having lunch together. We are still in need of liturgists to sign up for November and December, and there's an article in the Shield newsletter so that you can look at that and see what days coming up you might be able to sign up for that. Last Sunday, the Fall Carnival, the Trunk or Treat, was a huge success. So thank you to everyone who brought their cars and gave out candy, or to the youth and the youth families who put it on, to everyone who volunteered, and to those who contributed. The funds raised went to the Youth Mission Trip Fund, and so Alyssa and the youth were very happy with how that all turned out. And our fish basket today will be going toward our angel tree offerings that will be coming up in just a few weeks. I think that's what I have to announce. And so at this time, we will all take a few minutes to stand and greet those who are worshiping around you. If you're worshiping at home, greet one another in the chat box.
Thank you.
processional hymn, and the choir is coming in and the lights. And so if you would turn in the red hymnal to number 711, we're going to sing verses 1, 2, 4, and 6. We also remember a friend of St. Stephen's, Beth Quinn. You may be seated. And please join me now for the prayer for focus as printed in your bulletin. God of the tides, God of the changing seasons, at this time of year, we take notice of what is being let go of and what is clinging to our hearts. The pain of loved ones gone rests on our hearts, have children at home, bring them close to the screen so they can share in as well.
Because they're both wearing scarves. But November, we have what holidays in November?
Thanksgiving.
We give thanks, and what do? We welcome people, right? That's what we want. We want to be welcoming. So this is called Strictly No Elephants, and it's written by Lisa Manchu, Chip, and it's illustrated by Tian Yu. And I think you're going to really like this story. The trouble with having a tiny elephant for a pet is that you never quite fit in. No one else has an elephant, do you? No? Every day I take my elephant for a walk. He is a very thoughtful sort of walk. His is a very thoughtful sort of walk. So see, he's holding the umbrella for him. What a pet. He doesn't like the cracks in the sidewalk much. I always go and help him over. That's what friends do, lift each other over the cracks. Today I'm walking my tiny elephant to number 17. It's Pets Club Day, and everyone will be there. See, everybody's bringing their pets. Come along, there's a good boy. I coax him in the last few feet. It'll be fine. When I look up, there's a sign on the door. What do you think that sign says?
No elephants.
It says, strictly no elephants. And they crossed out the picture of the elephant. That's not very welcoming. My tiny elephant leads me back to the sidewalk, never minding the cracks. That's what friends do, have the scary things for you. So see, he's sad, the elephant's sad. And it's raining. Can it get any more depressing? Yes, it can. Did you try to go to the pet club meeting too? The girl asked. Yes, I say, but they don't allow elephants. The sign didn't mention skunks, the girl said, but they don't want us to play with them either. They don't know any better, I tell her. He doesn't stink. The girl adds, no, he doesn't, I agree. What if we start our own club? Come along, I say, making certain that my tiny elephant follows me, because that's what friends do. Never leave anyone behind. So look, oh, look at all the different kind of pets that weren't invited. There's a bat, a narwhal, an armadillo, a giraffe, a porcupine, ooh.
That's a penguin.
And a penguin. I don't even see it. We can play here, one of our new friends says. All of us. So they found a tree house. So we paint our own sign. They crossed out strictly no strangers, no spoil sports. They wrote, all are welcome. My tiny elephant will give you directions if you need that. So do you have any weird pets? Unusual pets?
I don't have chickens.
Chickens? Chickens? I had chickens. You know what I named them? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. No, I'm joking. I just like their eggs. So remember, just because somebody's different doesn't mean they shouldn't be welcome, okay? Let's have a prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for making us all different and wonderful. Help us to appreciate our differences as strengths and help us to share that love with all that we meet. In your name we pray. Amen. And so the rest of you can go to celebrations with Miss Mickey.
In the return of the prodigal son, a story of homecoming, theologian Henry Nouwen writes, and I quote, "Gratitude goes beyond the mine and thine and claims the truth that all of life is a pure gift. In the past, I have always thought of gratitude as a spontaneous response to the awareness of gifts received. But now I realize that gratitude can also be lived as a discipline. The discipline of gratitude is the explicit effort to acknowledge that all I am and have is given to me as a gift of love, a gift to be celebrated with joy." End of quote. On All Saints Day, we remember all who come before us for the love and the devotion they freely gave to others, and the legacy which they left behind. We are grateful to the people whose loving kindness and faithfulness are grounded in the Spirit of Christ. They remind each of us to the presence of God's call in our own lives. All that we are and have is given to us as God's gift of love, a gift to be celebrated with joy. We are a multi-talented congregation, sharing the call of Christ to serve all the neighbors that God has given us in the programs and ministry of St. Stephen's Church, our Oklahoma Conference, and the church in the world. And the best thing is that we are all involved in this process. Every one of us. We are all part of the future. And I am in gratitude for all that you have given us and all that is to come. Thanks be God. Amen.
In gratitude, we come to a place like this and we gather with people like this. And in gratitude, we give and we join our gifts with others so that all together we do so many things for justice, for mission, for community, and for our community life together. Let us pray. Gracious God, accept these gifts as you have so warmly opened your arms and hearts and accepted us into your life of faith. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of heavenly forces will prepare for all peoples a rich feast, a feast of choice wines, of select foods rich in flavor, of choice wines well refined. God will swallow up on this mountain the veil that is veiling all peoples, the shroud and shrouding all nations. God will swallow up death forever. The Lord God will wipe tears from every face, will remove the people's disgrace from off the whole earth, for the Lord God has spoken. They will say on that day, "Look, this is our God for whom we have waited, and God has saved us. This is the Lord God for whom we have waited. Let's be glad and rejoice in God's salvation." The word of life for this day.
Thanks be to God.
Our yearly gathering of Oklahoma United Methodists that we call annual conference. This year was a second year of start and stop, change dates, change the format, back and forth, back and forth. One thing that happens at the opening service every year is it is the service of remembrance. A memorial for all of the clergy and the clergy spouses who have died over the past year. I remember so many years standing beside my father as we sang the hymn that we came in with, "All for All the Saints," until it was my turn to be one of the family as he was remembered. This year, it was even different. Even though it was still just a one-year period of the people that we were remembering, there were more than two times the usual number of clergy deaths. 41, it's usually less than 20 for our size conference. So clearly some of those were COVID deaths. I knew of five, but mostly we were not sure why the number was double for this year. But this All Saints Day marks a year for all of us of significantly more death. So last Monday was actually All Saints Day, November 1st. And on that day, the worldwide number of COVID deaths topped 5 million. Just for perspective, the number of total people in Oklahoma is 3.7 million. So we don't like to say it, we don't like to see it, but death is a powerful force in our world. As one biblical commentator said, death exercises power over life both as individuals recognize their own mortality and as we suffer the loss of people that we love. And so we find ourselves this All Saints Day marking the lives of some that we have known well, of people that we have loved. Some of them died much too young, and some of them had lives that were full of many, many years. One of them was 100 years old. We mourn their loss. Each and every one of them have left behind broken hearts and fond memories. And so this community has this worshiping community to remember them, to hold their memories dear in all of our hearts. Also, on this All Saints Day, in a year unlike our other years, we try to mark the unimaginable deaths from the disease that is dominating our world. 5 million people each of them leave behind one person with a broken heart? No. Two? Three? Four? How many millions of people had their hearts break from all of these COVID deaths? Contemplating that is more than we can bear. It's more than we can put inside our heads. When we try to imagine it, it's a good thing to be in a place like this, a sanctuary, with a circle of people like this, a community of faith, to try to pack something into our heads that is more than we can pack in. And so on a day like this, we gather in this holy place to be together with these holy words that are for the whole world. The prophet said, on this mountain, the Lord God of heavenly forces will prepare for all peoples a rich feast, a feast of choice wines, of select foods, rich in flavor, choice wines, well refined, because God will swallow up on this mountain the veil that is veiling all peoples, the shroud that is enshrouding all nations. The words of the prophet Isaiah. And these words are for a community of people. They are for a whole nation. Not to mark individuals, but these words were spoken at a time when people thought their very existence was threatened, their very existence as a people, as a nation, that they could cease to exist collectively. And so these words were spoken to them, including these other words. God will swallow up on this mountain the veil that is veiling all peoples, the shroud that is enshrouding all nations. God will swallow up death forever. The Lord God will wipe tears from every face, will remove the people's disgrace from off the whole world. For the Lord God has spoken. And so this is a word that says that the memory of those people will go on so that they do not cease to exist. And actually, that came to be. Because these words were spoken 3,000 years ago, and here we sit today reading them and hearing them again. Their words, who they were, did not cease to exist. We still hear them. And so on All Saints Day, we are told again to remember those who have died, and not to remember in tears, but to remember in celebration. To remember by being glad that they were part of our lives. To celebrate that we knew them, the people represented by all of those ribbons. To be grateful that we knew them, that they imprinted our hearts, that they imprinted who we are now. Because that imprint makes us who we are. It makes you, you. And because of that, the imprint of those who are gone is here for us. It is a part for us to pass on to others in the love that we show to others. Thanks be to God. Amen.
service, we share joys and concerns. If you have others that you did not share aloud and would like to write them on the attendance pads, there is a page that you can write and then place that in the offering plate. If you are at home, you can send those through a text or email to any of the church staff. Let us pray together. Loving God, gracious and among us, the hand that reaches out when we are walking alone, the one who walks beside us, the one who is community. We are grateful for all of the ways in which we feel your presence. We are grateful for the gathered people of faith that bring presence to one another. We are grateful for the lives that have touched ours, impacted ours, made us who we are. On this day, there are things that worry us deeply. There are sorrows, some fresh and some very old. There are pains that we have shared and pains that we have not shared. All of these we've gathered together and we lay before you, knowing that in a holy space among your people, we can be safe, we can be cared for. Today we also pray for those whose problems are way beyond what we know, whose lives are very different from ours, people who have suffered, people who are in the middle of suffering. And we are always asking that you keep our eyes open, keep us aware of fellow human beings in need of compassion. And when we gather in this holy space, we also know that there is a long line, a cloud of witnesses, those who have come and gone before us, and those who have spoken the ancient prayer of the church. In that spirit, today we say the words, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of God. And now I invite you to take out the black hymnal. Number 2283 is a hymn titled For All the Saints. If you're comfortable doing so, please stand as we sing together.
Thank you.
hearts so that you can join in the responses. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Blessed are you, God of creation and all beginnings, God of Abraham and Sarah, of Miriam and Moses, God of Ruth and David, of the priests and prophets, God of Mary and Joseph, God of our mothers and our fathers, God of our children to all generations. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, 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 holy Lord. God of power and might.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. Broke the bread, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my very presence, and it is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his followers, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is a sign of a new covenant, given for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living community in union with Christ's offering for us. As we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us, gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the very presence of Christ, that we may be for the world the people of Christ, loved and freed. Renew today our communion with all your saints, especially those whom we have named this day. Since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, strengthen us to run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in total presence and we feast at the heavenly banquet. Through this one, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. The bread that we break makes it available to feed all of us. And the cup that we share, the sign of the new covenant, what unites us and gives us grace. These are the gifts of God given for you, the people of God. Our table of Holy Communion in this and in every United Methodist Church is always open to anyone who chooses to come. You are invited. For those who need to have gluten-free bread, it is available here on the table. For others, there will be stations where you can pass by to take your elements and return to your seats before we share all together. With those who are serving, please come forward. Table is set, and you are welcome. God, feeding us, sustaining us. Now that we have been with one another and encouraged and strengthened, may we go out to show the love and grace that you call us to. Amen. And now I invite you to stand for the benediction. People of God, blessed and beloved, strengthened and encouraged, go now to make a mark of love.